Hi, my name is Glen Drummond, and I'm Chief Innovation Officer at Quarry Integrated Communication. I'd like to give you a glimpse into the topic I'll be covering in my upcoming presentation to the Triangle Chapter of the American Marketing Association. The title of my talk is, How Can You Get Imaginary People to Do Real Work for You? Sounds like quite a trick, doesn't it? Well, in fact, the imaginary people I'm speaking about are personas, structures used for encoding and sharing customer insight. Personas leverage our innate human ability to relate to people and stories. And the real work personas do is to improve customer experience by helping the people who make it better. You might be thinking, that sounds like segmentation, and you're right, it is like segmentation. But personas go a step beyond traditional segmentation profiles because they convey more specific information about motivations. And just as important, personas disrupt unexamined assumptions and ingrained patterns of thought. Personas remind the designers of products and experiences that we're dealing with people here, not targets, not demographics, not segments, people. You can make lots of assumptions about a target, but a person retains a shred of mystery. And that mystery may in the end be an important key to accessing our imagination as we set about our work designing branded experiences. We're seeing clients use personas to influence both costs and revenues. For example, by narrowing product design focus around the motivations of a primary persona, we saw one client cut an expensive feature that would have been necessary in a one-size-fits-all product solution. Another client has used persona-based web design to better anticipate the goals and task model of their prospective customers and has improved their online lead capture as a result. We see personas as a core building block in lead nurturing programs and sales effectiveness tools aimed at increasing lead conversion, too. And we're speaking to several customer service providers who are interested in leveraging personas to match customers with the product, services, and support experience that will minimize customer churn. One of the things we find is that whether an organization is small, medium, or large, personas can really bring to life the discussion about the customer and the customer experience and make a positive impact in their business. So I'm really hoping we'll have a chance to talk about those ideas when we're together in Raleigh. I'd like to leave you with this question. If personas are fictional, how can you tell the difference between imaginary and fake? We'll discuss the answer to that question and more at the February 19 Triangle AMA luncheon. I look forward to seeing you there. I'm Glen Drummond. Thanks for listening.